Hello friends, I'm Chandran Iyer, editor and publisher of Corporate Tycoons magazine. Welcome to my YouTube channel where we interview business leaders and visionaries to find out the secret of their success. I have with me Mr. Anand Chordia, who is the technical director of Praveen Masalewale. This is an unusual interview in unusual time in view of COVID-19. Welcome to Corporate Tycoons, Mr. Chordia.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chandran ji. And yes, as you said, these are very challenging times, and it's like a reset button has been pressed by God, and it's testing times, time to look inward for everyone right now. So once again, I just want to thank you for having me here for this wonderful interaction.
Mr. Chordia, you are a third generation entrepreneur. Have you ever witnessed a challenge which is bigger than COVID-19 in the business sector?
Definitely. COVID crisis is, to me, it is social, economical, political, and also environmental crisis in many ways. Generally, the problems industry would face will have one dimension to it and not so many complex dimension to it. And this kind of a problem, I am a third generation, but I was talking with my grandfather, founder of our group, and I asked him that, have you experienced something like this in your entire professional journey or life? And he said, no, this is first time something like this is happening. And such kind of problem to me will give lot of huge reforms in security systems, in the influence of IT will play on every individual life or even the way companies will operate in future. So it's going to be a game changer, and it is going to, as I said earlier, it is a test for everyone to become and adopt lot more sustainable practices and strengthen the core of our business.
You're exporting your products across 5 continents, but the whole world is in a lockdown mode. How badly are you affected?
Yes, globally, entire global supply chain has been disrupted. So export is but obvious. We could start exporting after 20 days of lockdown because the ports were also not functioning smoothly. There was a shutdown at the port level also, and importers globally also have faced a lot of damage charges because their local supply chain was also not smoothly functioning. So the material was lying at the port itself. So there has been a lot of problems for exports which we have faced. Our product is a stable product, so it's safer that we could hold it back. But huge losses have been faced by people manufacturing perishable products, fruits, vegetables, frozen stuff, flowers, etc. There has been huge losses and problems seen, and in times to come you will see entire export regulation will change, the screening and security aspects will change.
What are the challenges for the FMCG industry in these times?
Yes, FMCG industry, if you see, it is material driven, it is people driven, supply chain driven, and all these aspects have got largely disrupted, including labors. In shortage of labors is felt all over the place. Supply for raw material as well as finished products, there has been issue. And also interstate, inter-district, within city movements have been very difficult. So there has been a big, huge business loss which FMCGs have faced. And consumer side also, if you see, the purchase pattern and the buying pattern completely has changed. So from both sides, the companies have got affected in a big way.
Do you think the government's stimulus package will give a boost to the sector?
Yes, as a package, it seems great. I personally felt a couple of things good. One was 10,000 crores are given to bring unorganized sector and these micro food processors to organized sector, which is a good thing, and there is some subsidy linked to that. I'm not going into the details of the schemes. Second good thing I found was there is a lot of support they are trying to create and give to herbal plantation and industry overall, which is also very important because it's our own uniqueness of our own country and which will build a lot of trade in times to come and also will support a lot of farmers. What I have not found clearly and not very happy about the announcement is there is no clarity. Some of the old schemes have been continued. Nodal agency is not specified. So I don't know how actually it's going to get translated to the beneficiary in some stipulated time, because it right now the importance is about the current time which industry is struggling for. So I was thinking there should have been some tax reforms, certain benefits in that if government could have announced, would have been very helpful to food processors and farmers. A huge support to cold storage at farm to farm gate scheme, cold storage schemes is given, and that is very important, I feel. To strengthen our agricultural sector, we definitely have to work a lot on empowering storage systems for most of the commodities India trade in. Food is used in fresh food, everyday purchased, and also used for processing. Good storage system will encourage farmers to store their goods for a certain time and fetch better pricing and make farming far more sustainable activity in times to come. And a good thrust has been given on that particular scheme, which I am very happy about. But as I said, there is no clarity in the actual translation to the final beneficiary. And that is the biggest question remains in the mind. So to me, it's a great announcement, but without no clarity.
Thank you for being on my show, Mr. Anand. It was a pleasure talking to you.